Hi, I'm Mark from L&M Small Engine. Today we're working on a TROY-BILT TB65SS string trimmer. It leaks gas just as fast as you put gas in the gas tank. Usually on, you know, a trimmer gets to a certain age, the lines get all brittle and they crack and break and everything. So I'll kind of show you an easy way to put them lines through the tank and everything. So hope you enjoy the video. Okay, as you can see, there's lines broken all over on this. Like this one right here, that's broke. And we're gonna replace this primer bulb right here. So when all the lines are missing, what the primer bulb does, you push the primer bulb and this center one right here, this long one, that pushes the gas back in the tank. So it sucks the gas from the other one through the fuel filter in throughout the carburetor and it recirculates and it goes back in the tank. That's what primes the carburetor. It fills the carburetor up full of gas. So when all the lines are all gone and mixed up, you don't know how to do it. That's just the simplest way to do it. This long center one that pushes the gas back in the gas tank. So, and I got a bunch of fuel line here, and I got some new fuel filter. So I know it's kind of hard to see this, but this is really small. So. The fuel filter, when I cut out, I'm going to push it back into the tank and we'll take the gas cap off. And get it out of there. Okay. And there we go. There's our old filter. We're just gonna put a new one on it. And this other one, that's our return line. Pop the old primer bulb out of there. So let's put the new primer bulb in. It only goes in one way. Just like that. So let's get that return line. it helps. If you make like an angle like this on there, it helps out a lot. Try a little smaller line here. You want that to go on there by like about an inch or so. Then we'll see a little bit better now. We got it in there. We're gonna cut it. Put it on to push the gas back in the tank. That's that center line. There we go. Okay, now we gotta turn this thing around. Camera set up here. Okay, there's two fill lines on the carburetor, one on top, one on the bottom. We're gonna put this one on the top, this one. Get it down there as far as you can. We'll feed it through this hole right here. That one will go on the primer bulb. So we'll grab this one. We'll put it on the other end of the primer bulb here. Okay, so we push the primer bulb, it's sucking the gas from the carburetor into the primer bulb back into the tank. So now we gotta make the one with the fuel filter from the tank, run it, and that goes to the bottom of the carburetor. So when we push this, it's gonna suck the gas from the tank in through the carburetor, out to the primer bulb, back into the gas tank. So you get that complete circuit. If you do it backwards, probably the only time it's gonna run, you'll run through the overflow until it gets like half full or so, then you gotta worry about dirt in the tank getting in there because there's no fuel filter on there. So there's only one way it will work right. Now, we're gonna run another line. And this one's gonna go in the tank. There see it better. Not much room here. So we're gonna put an angle on this and get it through the tank. We gotta push this one way in there so we can grab the hose and put the filter on. Slowly going in there. Okay, let's see if we can't fish it out of there and put the filter in there. I got a wire with like a little bend in it here. Let's see if I can't reach in there and grab it. And there we go. I'm gonna cut this end off here. And I got a little pair of needle nose here. I kind of made them so they slide into a fuel line to spread apart a little bit. This, you don't want to move it too much or else you'll tear it with this enough to get that filter on there. Get on there all the way so it don't fall off. Okay, then put in the bottom of the tank. Now we can go and hook it up to the carburetor here. Find some smaller diameter line here. Maybe some black line to color code it. And that goes through the hole. Like so. And I'll put this little T thing back in here. Some have them in there and some don't, I suppose, so you don't replace the whole line. Had it on there, so I'll just put it back on there. Like so. Put this other one on the other side. Now we'll just double check everything, maybe make sure there ain't no kinks. Double check everything. Being we have this part like this, let's go ahead and put a new spark plug in here. I always like checking these spark plugs on two cycle stuff to see how it's burning. Well, it's actually burning pretty good. Place the wire on it. There now. We could put some gas in it and make sure it works. Gotta run that primer bulb. Make sure we got it going the right way. Like the carburetor's leaking now. But the fuel lines are on there good. I'm going to see why the carburetor is leaking here.
Okay, we just had to tighten the diaphragm up a little bit. So. Something about this, but always make sure that gas has a complete circuit on it and should have no problems. But anyways, thanks for watching. You have a good day. Bye.
Hi, this is Mark from L&M Small Engine. If you like my videos, please like and subscribe. Thanks.